Now I'm gonna step inside the cabin. As you can see, the door sills are made of carbon fiber, CFRP, BMW calls it. It's a combination between carbon fiber and plastic. It's extremely strong and lightweight at the same time. The seat looks absolutely brilliant and it's pretty much comfortable all the time. I haven't driven the car too long by now, but I can already tell it's really comfortable. The rear seats as well. Now getting in. Let me adjust the seat. The steering wheel looks really nice. Really, really nice. It's all white with these eye blue accents. The display looks good, even though it's really small, to keep the weight down. The iDrive display is also quite good looking. It has a different graphics compared to the standard system. As you can see, it's dominated by blue colors instead of red. The HVAC controls are also different. There's no gear shift lever. That's the one thing that surprises most people, even though it does make sense. It's over here, the gear shift lever. It's a kind of stock right on the right side of the steering wheel column. It's easy to operate, actually. Just press start and switch between gears like this. I don't know why it's not working right now. I'm still getting used to it. So yeah, now it's in drive, reverse, neutral. And to park it, you press this button. That's it. The wood on the dash is eucalyptus. BMW actually chose this kind of wood because it is claimed to be the fastest regenerating wood you can get. So it's all in tune with this eco-friendly philosophy behind the i3. Actually, this car is really eco-friendly from start to bottom, because the CFRP used in its production is obtained at one of BMW's facilities in the US that uses electricity created with hydroplant. And the car is then assembled in Leipzig using solar power. And everything inside from this leather, I don't know if you guys can see it, it's really, really, really nice. This leather is naturally tanned using natural oils. The wood on the dash, as I said, is eucalyptus to regenerate as fast as possible. And yeah, looks great. We'll see how it drives in a couple of days. The car has 170 horsepower. It's about 1.2 tons in weight, and can accelerate pretty fast to 100 kilometers an hour, 7.2 seconds. It's really, really fast off the line. It takes you by surprise. And I'm gonna have to see just how many miles I can get on a full battery. Right now the dashboard computer says 124 kilometers, but we'll have to wait and see.
Gabriel here again with my recap of the BMW i3. After a couple of days with it, I can honestly say that I would totally buy one. Just the idea of not ever having to go to a petrol station again makes me, I don't know, makes me really, really interested in this car. As I told you in the previous video, unlike other plug-in hybrids or EVs out on the market, this one is truly an eco-friendly car from the beginning till the end. BMW made sure to include the manufacturing process into this philosophy, the I philosophy. So they're building the car using renewable energy. That's all you need to know. I explained it earlier. After a couple of days with the car, what can I say? I love the way it drives. It's really, really fast. The instant torque hits you in the back of your neck like nothing else. It accelerates quickly, especially in the pure EV guys. Without the range extender, you'll reach 100 kilometers an hour in just 7.2 seconds. With the range extender, that goes up to 7.9 seconds. But even so, it's really fast. You get about 120 kilometers of range inside the city. Going outside won't help you because this car wasn't designed to travel at high highway speeds. Another thing I love about it is that it's really small, compact. You do sit a bit higher than you expect. It's almost as high as in a crossover, if you will. But the turning radius is really small, and it really helps out around the city. It can park itself. The system works really well. Charging may be an issue. Unless you're using a fast charging station, it will take about 8 hours to fully charge your car, which is a lot, I know. But if you have if you can charge it at home, that won't be an issue. BMW says most commutes are only about 20 kilometers. So if you're just going to work and back home with an i3 every day, it should be enough for a full week. So during the weekend you could recharge your battery, and that's all. During my time with the car, the lowest range I saw was 60 kilometers, and after that I recharged it. I used a fast charging station, and it took about 90 minutes to fully charge the car. Of course, the battery was at about 30%. It wasn't completely empty. Using a wall socket, a 220-volt wall socket, it took about 8 hours. So that's definitely not recommended unless you don't need the car for a long period. I mean, you can charge it overnight. That's actually recommended because charging this car will ask a lot of the power grid, and you might have some surprises back at your home, having all sorts of issues with your electricity. What I don't like about the car? Well, the exterior design isn't exactly BMW savvy. I mean, it doesn't really look like a BMW. You can tell it's a BMW by the corona rings, the kidney grills up front with blue accents, and the short overhangs, but overall it's a weird looking car. I don't dislike it, but I don't love it either. It's a completely different story inside though, and that's something that took me by surprise. I mean, the interior looks absolutely great. The materials are great, even though you instead of plastic you get recycled PETs, recycled plastic bottles. The eucalyptus wood is absolutely brilliant, feels extremely nice to the touch, and everyone I talk to love the minimal approach for the interior. I also don't like about this car the way the rear doors open. It's not all that comfortable. I mean, even if you get them open, so in order to get them open, the driver and the passenger side doors have to be open, and then you can open the coach doors in the back. Even if they are open, you might have to fold the front seats because rear passengers might actually have an issue getting back in there. It's not a really wide opening. Even so, there's plenty of room for 5 people. Even though BMW set it up as a 4 people car, you can get 5 people if they can ignore the cup holders in the back. I love the fact that this car actually has plenty of range for daily usage around town, and it's so easy to use. It's another thing I love about the BMW i3 is the fact that you can actually drive it with one pedal. The regenerative braking is so powerful that it will actually bring the car to a complete halt. So basically, if you're approaching a red light, all you need to do is just approximate how long it will take the car to self-brake before it stops, and all you have to do is just take your foot off the accelerator like I just did, and I just came to a complete stop. So that's another thing I love about it. BMW calls it one pedal driving, and it's really good. It's impressive. It also helps recuperate a lot of energy. Another thing I just have to point out is the fact that I didn't expect the ride to be so harsh. The car is indeed riding on 19-inch wheels that don't have a lot of rubber on them, but even the dampers are set up to be extra sporty, extra harsh, and even in comfort mode, the car isn't extremely comfortable. You wouldn't call it comfortable, but it's not all that disturbing either. I guess you could compare it to a BMW 3 Series E46 with the M-Tech package. It's close to an E46 M3 in terms of ride harshness. That's I'm using the E46 M3 because that was the last one that didn't have adaptive dampers. So it's about that harsh. I'm guessing it was set up this way to, I don't know, make you feel like you're faster than you really are. I don't know, it's eerily quiet inside, so as long as you keep your radio off, people just won't hear you creeping up on them on the street. That's why during my time with the car, I, as you can see from the video, it's really shaky because the car's ride is really harsh. So I was saying, during my time with the car, when going to residential areas, I would roll down my windows and play some music in order for people on the street to hear me, because the car is so silent, they simply won't know you're behind them and they'll just hug all the road. I think I have to admit that I loved my time with the BMW i3. It's an experience I recommend to all of you. Just take one for a quick spin. You'll be sold, you'll get one, you'll never stop at a petrol station again. Electricity is a lot cheaper. You can even get a BMW's own charger that uses solar power to charge your car, and the energy will be completely green if that's something you worry about. So yeah, I give it a 5-star rating.